Krishna, Krishna Prasaya Putale, Srimati Bhakti Vedanta Swamini Dhyami. Om Agyana Timirandasya Giranjana Shalakaya Chakshur Militam Yena Tasmai Shri Guru Vinma. I was born in the darkest ignorance, and my spiritual master opened my eyes with the torch of knowledge. I offer my respectful obeisances unto him. Out of many millions of wandering living entities, one who is very fortunate gets an opportunity to associate with a bona fide spiritual master by the grace of Krishna. By the mercy of both Krishna and the spiritual master, such a person receives the seed of the creeper of devotional service. I am one such insignificant living entity, Guru Maharaj. By your causeless mercy, you bestowed upon me the priceless gift of Lord Chaitanya in the form of the holy name of Krishna and the literary incarnation of Krishna, the Srimad Bhagavatam. If you examine me, you will find no good qualities. Your mercy is all that I am made of. When I look at my life today, Guru Maharaj, I can't help but imagine what I would have been going through if I didn't have a bona fide spiritual master like you guiding me at every step. Last year, you had suggested that we should start looking into my formal education. We spent a good amount of time exploring various fields of specialization and thought a degree in psychology would be helpful to understand the human behavior in spreading the Krishna consciousness. When I approached you with this idea, Guru Maharaj, you showed me the big picture and advised me that practicing psychology wouldn't give me the result that I was looking for. Then, early this year onwards, we started to pay more attention to your lectures to understand your mood in the art of receiving and spreading Krishna consciousness. When we then were able to notice your gratitude and shelter rooted in the gift of Srimad Bhagavatam, Namaprabhu, and the Guru Parampara. This was quite enlightening to us, and I started studying Srimad Bhagavatam scrutinizingly, keeping it as the only subject of my study, with focus like never before. The more we meditated on your conviction, the more and more better options kept unfolding. Gradually, by your mercy, I was able to finalize my interest of specialization in life. Recently, he instructed my father to get me into college as soon as possible, according to the guidance of Her Grace Aradha Mataji. At first, I was slightly doubtful of my ability to get into university, but soon I became confident with your lectures. Guru Maharaj, I've heard you explain that if we take one step towards Krishna, he takes 100 steps towards us. And now I practically see Krishna's mercy manifesting in amazing and unimaginable ways in this period of my life. As I started processing my college application, by Krishna's mercy, everything suitable to my interests of study started emerging. When I came to the section of the application to list the subjects of my study so far, the only thing that I could think of right away was my extensive study of the scriptures. I was a little skeptical regarding my early eligibility, but my desire to fulfill your instruction left me taking full shelter of Krishna as the only support regarding my college. As I started pondering my disciplines of study so far, I began to realize that I could literally be accredited for a wide variety of skills, academic and general, from the extensive study of Srimad Bhagavatam, which is the answer for all questions, with its multidimensional, philosophical and social concepts. Another major part of the application was to present my profile in the form of essays, where they wanted to understand who I am as a person and how I could benefit humanity at large. My scriptural understanding was a perfect fill for this requirement. I can confidently state that there is no better gift to give to society Then the transcendental sound vibration of Krishna's holy names and the message of Srimad Bhagavatam, which holds the potency to transform every aspect of the society for the best. Therefore, I could successfully progress with my college application with the conclusive realization that the transcendental knowledge derived from Srimad Bhagavatam under the expert guidance of a bona fide spiritual master can make one succeed in all walks of life. Guru Maharaj, in conclusion, I would like to say that if you had not instructed my father when I was really young to make me study Srimad Bhagavatam, and if your lectures were not there to increase our faith in that best of scriptures and to remind us to take full shelter of Krishna, I would have still been in ignorance of my true identity and my purpose in life, which I have now realized a bit by your mercy. Guiding me throughout my life, you gave me a visionary's view of ISKCON as an organization to be continued over generations. Guru Maharaj, please empower me with the ability to serve Lord Chaitanya's Sankirtan movement to the best of my ability, and please bless me and pray for me so that I can imbibe the intention of the Acharyas, thus making myself an eligible candidate to be used as an instrument in the endurance and in and expansion of ISKCON over the years. Guru Maharaj, I wish you a very happy appearance day and pray to Krishna that you continue enlightening many lost souls like me all over the world for many more decades to come. Thank you, Hare Krishna. Your insignificant servant, Vishnu.